God loved the people of this world so much that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who has faith in him will have eternal life and never really die. God did not send his Son into the world to condemn its people. He sent him to save them. No one who has faith in God's Son will be condemned, but everyone who doesn't have faith in him has already been condemned for not having faith in God's only Son. The light has come into the world, and people who do evil things are judged guilty because they love the dark more than the light. People who do evil hate the light and won't come to the light because it clearly shows what they have done. But everyone who lives by the truth will come to the light because they want others to know that God is really the one doing what they do. Those words come from John chapter 3, verses 16 to 21. What is the difference between faith and belief? Everyone who refuses to fly in an airplane believes that airplanes exist. You can believe in God and His Son Jesus Christ without having any faith at all. Very often in today's world, men and women believe in God, but have no faith in Him. Of course, everyone who has faith in God also believes in Him. But the real question is this: how is it that you have faith in God? For what do you trust Him and Him alone in your life? What in your life would not be there except for Jesus? Do you trust God for your health? Or do you trust that the doctors will step in and save you if God fails? Do you trust God for your food? Or do you trust the grocery store for being there and hope that God blesses them to be able to supply your food? The Bible says that faith is the evidence of things not seen. In a sense, faith is trusting in God for things for which you can see no alternative. There is no backup plan to trusting in God. God is not simply the best insurance plan. Satan is the author of all the alternatives to trusting in God. Certainly, that does not say that God doesn't use doctors, grocery stores, and our jobs to funnel His resources to our lives. He does that every day. But if you believe in fulfilling your needs through some other way than trust in God alone, you're making Him very sad. Remember, every good and perfect gift comes from God and Him alone. Thank Him for every blessing, no matter what the human source. It all comes from Him. Thank you, Jesus, for being the source of supplying my every need. Help me not only to believe in you, but to trust you for everything. Praise your holy name now and forever. Amen.